Every one of us is created in the image of God, male and female, unique and unrepeatable. Redemption in Christ not only gives the human person incredible dignity in his or her body, but also reveals how we are called to love in and through the body. Thus, we support protection of human life from conception to natural death. The Church's advocacy for human life includes opposition to abortion, euthanasia, and assisted suicide. God loved you into existence and designed life as the natural fruit of conjugal love in order that we may participate in God's own life and love. Therefore, we reject human cloning, in vitro fertilization, and the destruction of human embryos for research. We recognize marriage as a lifelong bond between one man and one woman, and also recognize gender as objectively grounded in biology. We seek protection of human life through public policies that oppose the death penalty, torture, unjust war, the operations of drones for violent purposes, genocide, and attacks on non-combatants, trafficking in human beings for sexual, labor, or other purposes is also morally wrong. First, let's recognize that the right to life comes from God. And as faithful citizens, we must uphold the dignity of human life throughout society. We advocate for laws that support and protect the most vulnerable people among us. As we seek to help those in our community, let's remember the key issues of abortion, euthanasia, and physician-assisted suicide, particularly egregious in that these attacks come from within the family, against the most defenseless, and in such great volume. We are called to respond with mercy and compassion for the people facing these issues today. Abortion takes away the life of a child in the womb. Roughly 1.6 million babies have been legally aborted in Georgia since 1973. As a size comparison, that's more than every Catholic in the Archdiocese of Atlanta. Those who have experienced abortion are now speaking out on the harmful effects abortion causes to mothers and fathers. We express our belief in the sanctity of life through prayer, outreach, and legislation to protect the unborn. We work to provide compassionate assistance to those facing an unplanned pregnancy, as well as aiding struggling mothers beyond the birth of their child. We also support efforts to provide the healing and forgiveness that Jesus Christ offers to those who have fallen for the lies of the culture. Though we continue to see a variety of decisions from the courts about the issue of abortion, we are compelled to share the love and mercy of God with men and women in crisis, while also protecting life at its earliest stages of development. We can't just wait for the courts to dictate rules. We must also be proactive in our approach to this issue. Life is a gift of God until natural death. Euthanasia and physician-assisted suicide have made headlines throughout our country. As of January 2020, Maine became the 8th state to authorize physician-assisted suicide. Along with countless others across the nation, the Church teaches that every life has great value, even in the face of suffering. Medical progress connected to the end of life should have the goal of alleviating suffering, not eliminating persons. As we work to build a culture of life, our laws should protect the elderly, the disabled, and the terminally ill by communicating a message of hope that recognizes the value of every person. We urge you to educate yourself about all ramifications of the Church's advocacy for life and encourage all candidates for public office to support policies that protect human life from conception to natural death.